Hello, folks. I'll be online in just a few minutes drawing today's cartoon. See you in just a minute. Thanks for queuing up. Okay, here we go. Nice to see you all here today. I think we're just about ready to roll. Give me just a second here. Okay, hey, we're good. Everybody, thanks for coming back. Today I'm going to draw Trump and Rubio. I have my Flint, Michigan water. Excuse me, going to be a loud noise as I move my microphone. Get it as close to my mouth as it'll go. All right, microphone set. I set the table. I'm all ready to roll. Okay, so on my Wacom screen today, I've got Donald Trump and Marco Rubio in Google Images, all ready to go. And so, what the heck am I going to draw? I'm going to draw this. From my little post-it note, it's Marco Rubio, and he's got very large ears, and he says, "Hair Force One." And Donald Trump has hair that looks like an airplane, and he says, "Biggest ears I've ever seen." And they're pointing at each other, and this one should be fun to draw. Not sure how if I'm going to have time to color it this afternoon, but I'll give it a shot. If I get the caricatures let these guys write it. Shouldn't take too terribly long. And I'm all set. Okay. So I'm going to be here at least 2 hours drawing this puppy. Maybe 2.5. So sit back, relax, have a good time. Give me lots of chat comments to respond to, and you can keep me talking. Otherwise, I might go silent, and that would be boring. You can go to my blog and read about the adventure of my last podcast. If you were here for that, then you've got a good adventure under your belt. All right, just a second. Let me move my monitor there. All right, I think I'm ready to go. Okay. So this is what I'm drawing. Trump and Rubio. So he says, Air Force One. Do I want to have the speech balloons above their heads? I think maybe I do. Start off that way anyway. I genuinely haven't thought about how I'm laying any of this stuff out before I sit down at the drawing table here, so you have the full benefit of my complete lack of preparation. Well, it's nice to see a number of you here already. It'll be a while. Twitch is looking like it's giving me a little trouble. Let me know if everybody is seeing things okay. I presume everything is working. I've got to double check here. All right, I think everything is working. Even though, nobody is saying anything. Okay, I think we're ready to roll. Alright, Rubio's here. Get my Rubio images on the screen. I'm just sketching out general position yet. Here, I haven't. Oh! Kazokawa says he or she can see all right. Very good. And you're on Twitch. Good, good. Let me know if it starts dropping frames as well. I'm interested in that. Not quite sure how to fix that, but I'm interested to know if that happens again. So nice to see you here, Kazokawa. Set up there in big ears. He's pointing at Trump. Then here's Trump. Trump is on the right because he's more of the gag because his hair as a airplane is supposed to be funny. I'll have to figure out what hair as an airplane looks like. I haven't quite figured that out yet. And Trump also has a lot more of the neck going out at 45 degrees than Rubio does. So let's get the He also seems to have more width. There he is. He can have a lower arm pointing back at Rubio. Rubio needs more width as well, doesn't he? Let's move him a little bigger. The tell you, the extent of my visualizing this was this. There is no more than that there. That is all that exists. Okay, if Trump's got the airplane, he's got it going like that over his forehead. He's got a wing here. Be kind of funny. And the tail. More funny stuff happening back there. I think airplane hair is funny. Rubio's gonna have has that round top of the head. He has an excellent jaw. Rubio has just has a great jaw. And any of you 10 people that are following me, if you would please, I mean that are watching me, if you would please follow me, that would be just lovely because I do need the follows. I need the follows and I need the nice chat comments. Bob Watkins writes, "Hi, Daryl. Nice to be able to watch another of your drawing sessions." Well, thank you very much, Bob. Rubio has interesting receding hairline. Thank you for following, Kimchi Bakum. That's very nice. And Bob Watkins as well. I appreciate both these lovely follows. Thank you. That is very nice of you both. You notice how I break through my paper every so often? And that makes all these little marks here on my tabletop. It's past times when I broke through the paper. So you want to make the top of his hair come back after the roll back of the top of his forehead and his receding hairline. He seems to have a big head of hair, but it is the tide is on the way out with that head of hair. All right, and he needs giant ears because that's the gag. He in fact has tremendous earlobes, just fantastic earlobes. You know, the structure of an ear is outer rim. In this inner rim, you have a Y break that varies on different people's ears and comes back around and creates this inner well. You have a little lump here over the inner well. This Y can come and join with the outer rim and come back here. Outer rim can disappear at any point. Y interior rim can differ and be disappearing or joining at any point. And this interior area of the ear can be different on people as well. But the point is, you want to get one of these basic ear shapes. And fit this Y-topped interior rim into the ear. That's how you draw an ear. That's my how to draw an ear video. through the paper all the time. I really need to buy some better paper. Ugh. Jeez, today's a brutal day on the paper. I may make Trump's airplane a little bigger. Let's see how it works out. But I think I've got the basic Trump airplane hair shape down. I should probably stick this on here since I haven't dealt with Nightbot. And so if you type in /topic, you're not going to get anything because I haven't dealt with it. There are too many things on my checklist for starting off a new stream. The checklist is just too long. And there's just one of me. Just threshing out some more details, futzing around. I see that my Trump is gonna need to come down a little bit more to the ground. Match the Rubio at the horizon line. It's always good when you got him standing to have a little bit of action in the knees, I think. I used to have art directors complain about my bent knees, saying that they looked like everyone was pooping. And I don't think that. I like bent knees. I suppose it's a little bit ape-like, but that's fine for these Republican Neanderthals. Ape-like, good. Ape-like, good. Republican, good. Shoes here. Remember to follow if you haven't followed. We have two nice follows today. That's so nice. My Flint water. His arm needs to come back out. Another thing you want to do with when you throw a body together is you want to think, here, I've got this arm coming up this way, and that's got some weight that needs a counterbalance. And where is that counterbalance? Counterbalance is his arm back here, countering the weight of that arm out there. And that's why having this arm back here looks right. Same with the Donald. Seems to me the Donald's suits are awfully loose fitting. Okay. Donald. Oh, I think the airplane's looking kind of funny. I do need that wing going back rather than down. When I've got them a little better in place, I'll be able to do a little better job of placing the speech balloons. I'm hearing news stories about how Donald Trump has stubby fingers, but I don't notice that in any of the photographs. His fingers look fine to me. It's hard to do caricatures of fingers because people tend not to remember what fingers look like. If you're doing someone that's very familiar to you, a family member or something, the fingers are more important. But on news figures, people just don't know what their fingers look like. Thinking of where the wrinkles go in a suit, you have to emanate them out over there. Wonder if I ever erased. Bob Watkins notes. No, I erase constantly. That's why I work in pencil. I work very messy. And this is just a thinking process now. You know, this airplane looks a little bit like a sperm whale. Donald Trump's on TV as we speak. I think his hair is really kind of hard to draw because it's more like a cloud. It's not, except for the stuff where he's got the heavy goop over the ears, in front of his forehead, it's a cloud. I also have trouble finding him in profile. I think I'm going to need to do him at 3/4 view to get a likeness. Chin that's going to want to go straight back that way. Now, is his head too big? Bring his neck up to there. See if I'm happy with that. Not sure that I am, but we'll leave it there for a moment. Hello, Funky Monkey. Nice to see you here. You do a pretty good job of finding me every time I unexpectedly come on to stream. Alright, his neck's gotta change. His chin's gotta improve. I think my first try at a likeness kinda came out close enough. But, Funky Monkey writes, I'm just on here, and then I'm like, ooh, Daryl's online. Well, good. That's what I like to see. I should draw 2 to 3 cartoons a week. I think 2 to 3 is a lot. One of the, Donald Trump, yes, I watched Last Week Tonight as well. We'll lift his ear up a little bit more. This is a silly cartoon, I shouldn't mind going extra big with the heads. I think Donald Trump's actually taller than Rubio. I like his arm coming up and Donald's arm coming under. So if I've got a speech balloon here and a speech balloon here, square them off to get them a little closer. That probably works. A little bit of haze behind the speech balloons. More horizon line. This is my rough sketch. In case you missed. Oh, we've got 21 people now. That's kind of cool. People don't show up on YouTube. Twitch is the only place where people show up. Funny to see the consternation in the press about Donald Trump right now. The press likes to think that they have power, and so here they are doing all they can to diss Donald Trump. You know, how many times can we put Trump and Ku Klux Klan and white supremacists together? Why the heck don't people listen? I think it gives got to give the press some humility about their lack of influence. They pull out all the stops to crush this guy and nothing works. I think the hands need to be a little bigger. This is a goofy cartoon. The heads are too big on the bodies. I've got to get my universe right here. In my sketch, it's probably funnier because I've got a bigger airplane. I do have room for more of the front of the airplane. That looks a little more correct airplane-like, doesn't it? Get him a little farther back. I do a heck of a lot of futzing and fiddling and not getting things right. Oh, and breaking through my paper. All right, Rubio. And, you know, just so you know, this is what I'm looking at when I'm looking at my own monitor right in front of me. That's Rubio on Google Images. This is what cartoonists do these days. You bring up the Google Images. Body needs to come back more. His tie needs to come in this way. Needs more butt back here. Rubio. First pass on Rubio. Not sure if I'm gonna like it. Hey, Letitia Wicks. Thank you so much for following. I do appreciate that. Letitia Wicks. Cute little button nose. Oh. Let's lay him out a little differently. I'm going to make the ears even bigger as well. I think I need to go a little cartoonier with everything. Because this cartoon is so silly. Now, Ruby is kind of interesting in that his left eye, you see the top of the eye, comes down over the eyelid. He's got a flat left eye, and on the R right, his left eye, he's got a big eyelid. And he's got these big eyeballs. He's got a good bunch of volume to his upper lip. Well, clearly I don't have him very well yet, but that'll be Marco placeholder. Yeah, that's got to go. That's all wrong. So what I do when I draw caricatures is I draw them over and over and over again until I get them right. And sometimes I'm drawing for quite a while. Donald went pretty quickly today. Rubio may take a while. Rubio's easy to do simply with button eyes and button nose. Extra simple Rubio. Nah, maybe he's not so easy. We're gonna struggle with him for a while. Hair rounds up that way. His eyebrows would be down here. Just make him a little more angry. Thank you. May want to tip Donald's head up a little bit so that they're facing at each other a little more. I will figure that out when I go to the finished line art. You guys are so silent. I'm just not getting comments. Yeah, he's got a little more chin than that, doesn't he? His head's getting onto the big side. He's got a pretty good looking chin, I think. Nothing in the way of pillars. Pillars being the lines on the sides of, between your nose and your mouth on the sides. Marco doesn't really have much pillar going on. That's a little more right for his mouth. Fix his eyes. Hello, Theo. The guy Trump is pointing at is Rubio. And I haven't got Rubio right, so I'm working on him. Let's start over. I'm going to give him more cheek, although he really doesn't have much in the way of cheek. But he does have that baby face. And I do need to tighten his head up a little bit. So I'm going to go for a little bit more of a lima bean, see if that helps. If I keep having trouble with him, I can always go back to some of my old drawings, see what I did before. So Bob Watkins asks about why his head is so big, not seeing his baby face quality. It's because I'm not happy with it yet. Get there. It may take me a while. He's got that large Y break at the top of his nose. Eyebrows are quite far apart. I'm gonna have to go for another piece of paper on Rubio. I'm not happy with him. Giving me some trouble today. Let's do a better Rubio. Hello, Diego Jedan. Nice to see you there in Ecuador. Should have a neck there. Trump had that big, Rubio had that big bump to there. We'll get rid of this. So let's go for the baby face. I think Bob Watkins writes about the baby, right about the baby face. Right on the top of his head. There, there. And the giant ears. Needed to be bigger. He doesn't open his mouth that much except when he's smiling. Don't really want to smile. His mouth pops out. That's more of a Rubio mouth, huh? I think I'm getting a little closer. To make him more of a baby face, you have to lose more of his chin than he actually has. His chin really isn't that bad. Comes out even more. He's got giant earlobes. Oh, well, thank you for updating Nightbot, Theo. Okay, I think I've kind of got Rubio. Let's see if I can improve him a little bit when I I could give him a water bottle over here. Not sure I want to do that. But I'll think about it for a few minutes. See if I can change Donald a little bit. I might move Rubio's arm up a little. Note to self, arm up. Okay, so Rubio says hair Force 1. Donald says biggest ears I've ever seen. The airplane can be a little bigger. So a little bit bigger airplane, a little bit bigger wing. Is that enough for me to start drawing on it in the finish? Clean up a lot of the errors that I have in this sketch when I do the finish. Okay, the Donald's eyes. I could open his eyes, I could leave him squinty. I think maybe the Donald needs a little more work. Ducky lips are always good for the Donald. Not sure that helped. He needs more eyebrow stuff going on. His head needs to come up a little more to Rubio head level. I can shorten a speech balloon. I've ever seen. Lift this airplane up here. This one has so many little things that need to be in just the right positions. Now let's rethink the Donald's mouth. I like this cartoon. It's silly. I need to do things that are more silly than symbolic. People like silly better than symbolic. Okay, the top lip doesn't curl. That. Nah, it doesn't look quite right. I think I'm gonna need the ducky lips. Funky monkey. Why did you put a plane on his head? Because Rubio says Air Force One as one of his jokes on the stump. And Donald Trump talks about Rubio having the biggest ears he's ever seen. So I illustrate both. Air Force One and biggest ears I've ever seen. And that is the purpose of the cartoon. Oh, that's so wrong. Let's get the ducky lips right. Guys are giving me trouble today. I'm just not in my best caricature mode. Keep doing it till I get it right. Before we did this live streaming, you never knew how much I fiddled around to get things right. People presume I get everything right in the first try. Ears can be bigger. They can be really big. Airplane could be bigger too. Some days better than others. This will be a nice cartoon, though. Oh, Diggledowski says, one some days better than others. I'll get there. I think I'm fine from here up. I could move the airplane up just a little bit on his head, reveal a little bit more of the bushy eyebrows. I think I will do that. Airplane up just a little bit. Thank you. close. I'm not right on the lips, am I? Even the ducky lips have to be just perfect Trumpian ducky lips. He does this O thing with his mouth. One problem with Trump is that he's not a bad-looking guy. I keep going back to the same things, huh? That's wrong. If I was closing his mouth, Trumpian Ducky Lips. Isn't that a band, writes Bob Watkins. Perhaps it should be Trumpian Ducky Lips. I think I should probably start doing these kinds of futzing around bits on the final piece of paper. Move it along. Move it along. Okay, let's put him here. Look at how much I broke through the paper. My goodness. Drawing hard today. So I'm going to start off with his airplane hair, then move that to a place on his head that pleases me. Hey folks, remember to follow me. I do appreciate the follows. Okay, airplane hair. I need my glasses for this. Okay, the glasses. Sorry about that. Old man glasses. All right. Trumpy hair as airplane. The spot. There's his wings. That's the airplane here. Now, where should the airplane go? Let's rethink the air position. I think it needs to go up a little bit to show some eyebrow. So let's move it. Just a skosh. Eyebrows. These wonderful expressive eyebrows. And I only seem to get his eyes to work when they're squinty. Folks are so quiet. Thank you. Notorious PU says, looking great. No Red Ties says, he asked if that was vellum. He asked if that was vellum. Yes, it is vellum. But I don't recall who asked that. Yeah, I draw on vellum. Okay, now let's rethink his head again. Do I want to point the Donald more up toward the Rubio? And drop the Rubio a little bit. I think maybe I do. So he was here. I'm going to move him up. Oh, Diggle asked. Yeah, I use Duraline vellum. I like it. It's got a nice color of the paper, feel of the paper. It takes my pencil very nicely. Biggest ears I've ever seen. The Phoebe uses this same vellum. That's interesting. It is not an uncommon vellum. It's in any decent sized art store. You can buy a pad of it. It has to be a real art store. There can't be a Michaels. Or a Hobby Lobby. It's got to be a genuine art store. Give them pinstripes today. We'll see on that. Diggle writes, is Trump your favorite candidate to draw this election? I haven't got my Trump down yet. You saw how I struggled with him today. I'm not quite up on my Trump. I can draw Obama with one hand tied behind my back. But not quite ready for Trump yet. I'll get there. Pretty soon he'll just resolve himself in a few simple lines like Obama. Gotta give him time to evolve and percolate. They'll get there. I thought Air Force One was kind of funny. I think it's going to be a new imperative for presidential candidates to hire comedy writers. It's a little funnier with the speech balloon, huh? Have it go behind the airplane. Yeah, he's gonna have pinstripes today. Okay. The airplane is the goofiest thing, even though Rubio's got ridiculous ears. And you know, you want to put your gag at the end, so I'm presuming you read it this way and then you end up with the airplane. At least that's the layout plan. Well, his arm is not right. I'm not pleased with his arm. I'm gonna redo the whole friggin' arm. I'm having all kinds of troubles today. You get to see me at my most indecisive with this drawing. And it's a simple, stupid cartoon. Perhaps it's the simple, stupid ones that make me struggle more. Alright, let's draw his feet in. Didn't think I'd be drawing at all today. The electric company turned my power off to do scheduled maintenance around the neighborhood. And, turned it back on early enough for me to draw a cartoon today. Could still have my power off. I'm at the mercy of the whim of Southern California Edison bastards. You know, the other day, I screwed up my streaming and ended up streaming live all night long while I was asleep in my bed right next to here, broadcasting my snoring. Then when I woke up in the morning and I came in and saw, oh no, I streamed myself snoring all night. There were 20 people watching my feed of nothing. 20 people, and I'd gotten a half a dozen people to follow during the night while I was snoring. So now I've got 19 people following when I'm actually drawing. Perhaps I should go back to bed. The man was trying to keep me down, but failed. Oh, the man at Southern California Edison. Bastards. Yeah. I should challenge those power outages, scheduled power outages. First Amendment violation, huh? They're cutting off my free speech. Okay. I think his arm needs to come out that way. Bob Watkins writes, oh, Diglebowski writes, LOL, the Phoebe has done that four times, I did it once. Well, you know what happens is, Air Force One, that's funny, Hair Force One and Air Force One, they both work, don't they? OBS will sometimes freeze, so I click on stop streaming, but I have to remember to look to see if the button actually changed. Just clicking on it is not enough for it to actually change, and also at the same time, I hosted somebody else's feed, so I looked at the feed, I saw it was hosting somebody else, that was fine. Didn't think about it coming back to my room after the other guy stopped streaming. You know what? I'm gonna let this percolate for a while because I need to think about it a little more. And so I'm going to draw pinstripes, which require very little thought. And will let me take a fresh look at everything else when I've spent a little time drawing some mindless pinstripes. pinstripes are like taking a break and working on something else, which I used to always do before the streaming. I would have a number of projects going on. The end of the day today, I need to do the artist royalties for February. I put that off until the end of the day because people can still buy things in February through the end of the day and change people's royalty reports. But they're not going to buy anything now at 4:51 Pacific time. Dick Bowski writes, man, I can see your years of experience the way you just crank out the letter. Syndrome Down, nice to see you. Syndrome Down, hey, have you followed me yet? I really need the follows. Come follow me, Syndrome Down. You can do it. Just give me a follow. Yeah, the thing about these caricatures is that they are unforgiving. You either make it look like people, or you're a sissy cartoonist who has to make it look like whatever you drew and put a friggin' label on it. And I'm not a natural caricature artist. I have to struggle with it every time. There are some caricature artists I look at that just amaze me with how they get everything right every time. And that is not me. Oh! Syndrome Down, thank you for the follow. So, pinstripes. I like the way that pinstripes give tone and, did you follow Syndrome Down? You gave me a nice heart. Do I draw Hitler's look at please? I have noticed a lot of the international cartoonists drawing, Hitler metaphors with Trump, I also note how MSNBC and NBCNews.com are trying as hard as they can to associate Trump with the Ku Klux Klan. And I put that down to media desperation. Desperation at the fact that no matter what they write to demand that people not like Donald Trump, they're liking him anyway. And that makes the media feel frustrated and powerless, and there aren't a lot of times when the lack of influence of the media has their nose rubbed in their lack of influence so thoroughly as Trump is having here. And that, I think, makes the media a little bit desperate in the respect of all of those Hitler references. Anyway, you see what's so nice about the pinstripes is they end up being a kind of a cross-hatching that defines this three-dimensionality. And it's also a metaphor for rich folks. Syndrome writes, could you tell me the time, please? Here in California, it is 4:55 p.m. in the afternoon. So 5 o'clock for me. I'm hoping to have this done, at least the line art on this done by 6 o'clock so I can go out to dinner. Big Lebowski writes, creates form as well. Yeah. So I do enjoy the pinstripes. And I put the extra time into the pinstripes. Pinstripes are fun. It makes you look like you felt the form. You felt that he had real mass. Bob Watkins writes, love the way pinstripes look at the folds. SMH, amazing. What is SMH? I've got to learn my acronyms. Yeah, I have to think as I draw the pinstripe. One thing that you notice among the beginning aspiring cartoonists is they'll draw things like pinstripes and not relate them to the form. They do cross-hatching and don't relate the cross-hatching to the surface that they're modeling. They think of the cross-hatching as a pattern. They draw it kind of like... Oh, shaking my head. Oh, well, that's very nice. Thank you, Bob. They think of cross-hatching kind of like a piece of Zippitone to show my age. And that's not what cross-hatching should be, recreating a piece of Zippitone. I'm also going to give him some gray tone on this suit, so the pinstripes I'm doing are not going to do the whole job. Let's give him a dark tie. Shaking my head, huh? You know, when I was with MSNBC.com, I would often get emails from them that were full of acronyms. And one thing that I was getting a lot was, need this EOD. Need EOD. I had no idea what EOD was. It was end of day. And I found that out after some misunderstandings. EOD. Oh, ridiculous EOD. You think things have some kind of tech meaning. They do not have a tech meaning. Shaking my head and EOD. Yeah, see how he needed the pinstripes? Without the pinstripes, he was just not interesting enough. They tend to wear these dark gray suits that have no detail and nothing interesting going on. So, Syndrome Down, did you follow me? Or had you already followed me? And why are you interested in Hitler? Yeah, I notice in discussions about cartoons, Hitler comes up pretty quick in each discussion. Hitler, Ku Klux Klan. Today it's Trump and David Duke. There was a website that tricked him into retweeting some quotes by Mussolini. I think the press is just going batshit crazy, as Lindsey Graham says. Trump. I think the airplane's funny. Oh, Bob Watkins, sorry to see you leave. Thank you for joining me today. I think these lines on his neck are looking a little bit too harsh as I've added these pinstripes, and they kind of blend with the pinstripes, don't they? It's going to have to loosen up a little. That's a little better. Lebowski writes, "See, I thought the media treated Trump as he is such a personality, created Trump as he is such a personality. He's a creation of the media." All right, let's reposition Rubio. I think I'm going to draw Trump's hand a little bit later. Ah, my tape is too strong. I usually use this low-tack drafting tape, and for some reason I can't find it right now. Okay, where do I want him to be? Stinking tape. It's too strong. Trump needs to come up, Rubio needs to come down. I think I want them to be a little closer together, but I'm not quite sure. All right, let's give Trump his hand. For now, I give Trump his hand. Everybody thinks it's so much easier for me that I should be drawing these really fast, not putting so much time and thought and erasure into things. The pencil and the erasing seems to surprise people. But No, I struggle with everything. He's looking Trumpian. Dick Lebowski writes, "This is certainly different than the last two elections. I expected all the crazies to cycle through, then the most moderate candidate to prevail." Well, don't know what's going to happen, but I don't see any moderate Republican candidates. And I think of Trump as rather mild compared to all those other nutty Neanderthal Republicans. Compare him to Rubio and Cruz? I don't think Trump looks so nutty by comparison. I suppose Jeb Bush was the moderate. John Kasich is the moderate. But they strike me as guys that want to jump into every war. Okay, should I lower Rubio's head a little bit? I think I will. Boy, this is extra sticky tape. I've got to get my drafting tape back because this is just a pain in the butt. Air Force One. Jeez. All right, if his arm's going to be there, I'm going to tell you what, I'm going to put his arm in first. Fit him onto his arm. How's that? Dick Lebowski says, "Yeah, I expected Jeb, but man, he made vanilla ice cream look exotic." I didn't like Jeb. I guess I was not the only one. I think if I had my choice of all the guys, I will vote for whoever is least likely to put us into somebody else's war. And my judgment of the Republicans was that the least likely to jump into a war was Rand Paul. So, he would have been my first choice. And I'm kind of guessing that Trump might be less likely to jump into everybody else's war, the way he talks about let Russia have Syria, do what they want. I kind of like that. So, I am not the most anti-Trump guy. And, I don't think this is a terribly anti-Trump cartoon. His hair is funny. Sketch 4565 writes, "I'm from Florida. Jeb is not a moderate. He is not." Very good, Sketch 4565. And remember, Sketch 4565, that you need to follow me. I need follows here. My son uses Twitch for video games, and he talks to me about Twitch etiquette. And one of the Twitch etiquette things he mentioned is that people on Twitch do not talk about politics. Here I am, political cartoonist. And I expected a lot more talk about politics on here. And I find that there's a lot more talk about how to regarding the art than there is about the subjects I'm drawing. Already have. Oh, well, thank you very much, Sketch 4565. I appreciate it. Digglebowski writes, oh, I know regarding Bush, but he was trying to play a moderate. Well, moderate in some respects, but not in the jumping into war respect. I've got to stop using the friggin' scotch tape. Okay, where do I want Rubio? Friggin' scotch tape! Wrap that over there. Where do I want Rubio to be? Let's move him. A little bit lower on the head, then I'm going to lift his body a bit. And I will bring him up on my monitor. Here you can see what I'm looking at on the monitor. My slow OBS does not want to respond. On the monitor, I've got Marco Rubio here. Okay. Pleased with that. I'm not sure I am. I may keep fiddling with Rubio for quite a bit. He's really got pretty interesting eyes, very asymmetrical eyes. Thank you. Trump needed a little more nose weight there. Rubio kind of funny. I'm not sure he's right, but he's funny. Have to think about him for a minute, think if I got him right. There's aspects of him that I like. I like the asymmetry of his eyes. This is the one that has the eyelid. Forehead. Has everybody gone quiet? No red ties. Right, it's dinner at 6. Sounds aggressive at this point. Oh, it does, doesn't it? I'm going to need to pick this up tomorrow to do the coloring anyway. So if I don't finish, I will finish tomorrow just before I do the color. Let's try this big funny ear. Gonna go up like that. Down like that. What does his ear detail looking like? He's got a little bit of this thing going on. let's have another one on the other side. I'm gonna give him 2 beers. Big ears. That's right, says Digglebowski. Big ears. Let's reposition our Rubio feet. I've been drawing this for 2 hours. That's pretty long. I see people coming and going here and not stopping to follow. Thank you again, No Red Ties, for following. Nah, I'm not gonna give him a water bottle. Thank you. Ruby is going to need pinstripes as well. Yep, no water bottle. Not related to dinner, though. Just didn't want the water bottle. Gonna give him pinstripes, though. Darker pinstripes than the Donald. Looks like the stream is going okay. Not looking at technical problems today. I'm going to force quit OBS when I'm done here. Make sure it's off. I think giant ears and airplane hair is fun. This isn't a cartoon with a lot of substance, but I'm not drawing Hitler. Piece of sandpaper over here on my right, where I chisel up my points. I think that I may, when I pick this up again in the morning, I may be dissatisfied with my Rubio. Embark on a new Rubio face. like the pinstripes, though. I think neither of them actually wears pinstripes. They wear plain black or dark gray suits. Wear plain ties. I like to draw striped ties. Politicians do not dress to suit the needs of cartoonists. There was one time I remember when Obama wore a tan suit for some important address or something, a news conference maybe. And boy, all the cartoonists were drawing him with the tan suit immediately. Something they'd never seen before, and I think have never seen since. He probably got a bad report on efficacy of tan suits. So tomorrow, I need to knock this puppy out, and then start on all the artist's February royalties. Where do I want his feet to go? Sigalbowski writes, I remember W wearing a tie for a speech that created a moire pattern on TV. Maybe that's a strategy for Hillary. If she needs to address the email crisis or something, she should do it in a dress that creates a moire pattern on TV, and they're not going to want to show that. Ha ha ha, that's a strategy. still got my post-it note here with the original sketch. So Dick Lebowski, you like my Hillary strategy, moiré pattern strategy? She releases all of the... They release all the emails from the State Department on a Friday night. Apparently this last Friday was the last of the emails, wasn't it? Or maybe it's this Friday. But you know, Friday night is the lousiest time for getting news coverage on anything. It's kind of like if you draw an editorial cartoon on a Friday afternoon after the papers have closed on the East Coast. They've already put together their Sunday editions, Sunday opinion sections on Friday afternoon because everybody has the weekend off. So you can see how releasing her emails on Friday night misses the whole weekend Sunday paper schedule. Everybody's gone home. Then when they get it on Monday morning, it's old news. Yep. It's also the day you lose your editorial cartoon if you release it then. Cartoon is old on Monday. Interesting exception is USA Today, where everybody goes to work on Sunday to put together their Monday editions. They don't print on the weekends. Their Friday edition is their weekend edition. They come back to work on Sunday, and they want to see the cartoons that the cartoonist posted on Saturday or on Sunday. Well, most cartoonists are not at work on Saturday and Sunday. They did their last cartoon on Friday. We'll be doing their next cartoon on Monday. But if they want to get in USA Today, they should have posted their cartoons Saturday afternoon or Sunday morning. Enough cartoonists are on to that trick that it doesn't matter that I mention it. And I'm not sure it's worthwhile trying to get into USA Today since your cartoon is degraded by the schedule for the other newspapers. Excuse me, got the hiccups. And USA Today only pays $50. But the cartoonists all like to be in USA Today. Get a different crowd of people seeing your cartoon. Crowd of people that stays in a hotel. Make Rubio's face a little smaller on the same size head. Decide that tomorrow. folks are not very chatty. I hear from Digglebowski. But there's 15 of you. Yeah, I don't quite have Rubio right. I'm going to have to fiddle with him in the morning. Take out that eye, and he looks better. Take out that eye, and he looks better. And I can shorten his nose and make his face a little bit smaller. The facial elements within the size of his head a little bit smaller. Folks are so quiet. Okay, Big Ears Airplane could have been sillier. Maybe I drew it too much on the... detail side. Okay. 5:45. I think I'm gonna set this pup aside, pick him back up in the morning, see what changes I need to make to Rubio to get him right, because he's not quite right, and color it. So if you like, folks would like to rejoin me tomorrow morning, maybe tomorrow afternoon. Tomorrow's Super Tuesday. Possible that could be the end for Rubio. Okay, this shall... be picked up tomorrow I will scan and color and fix Rubio's face and probably also do some more to his ear. I think I'm not quite happy with his ear. See how I feel about that ear in the morning. Digglebowski writes, cool stream. Glad got to see you draw. Only see you draw. Only seen you in Photoshop. Oh, well, do you know, Digglebowski, that all of my videos, except the one after I ran the thing all night long, recording my snoring, all except for that one, they are archived on YouTube, and you can get to them most easily from DarylCagle.com. So go to DarylCagle.com, click on a recent cartoon you like, except for the one with Trump planting his flag in the butt of the elephant, and you can watch the full YouTube video. See me drawing everything. I have nothing to hide. All of my errors and fiddling and getting things wrong, I display for the world to see. Okay, this one is going to be picked up tomorrow. So, yes, everyone, go to DarylCagle.com. Watch the past episodes of Daryl drawing his cartoons. And tomorrow I will color up this puppy and oops, there, now maybe you can see it a little better. I don't know, much darker. And I'll see you guys later. Thank you so much for watching. And Theo, if you want to host someone else's stream, go ahead and host them up, and I think we're ready to go. Thank you, folks. I will be back tomorrow. So, see you later, and thanks again.